More than 100 Canadian Army reservists recently gathered at 4th Canadian Division Training Center near Meaford, Ontario for Exercise Highland Bomber II. Today, we're joined by the Unit Operations Officer and key planner of this joint exercise, Captain Rhys Stevenson of the Royal Highland Fusiliers of Canada, to tell us more. Thanks for joining us today, Captain Stevenson. I want to start off by asking, what did this training focus on and what made it stand out from regular reservist training events?
Well, this particular exercise is actually a series of exercises whereby we synchronize our collective training schedules between combat units, combat support units, and combat service support units. As you can imagine, this required a whole lot of planning and effort and involved a lot more moving parts than would normally be expected from a reserve exercise from just one single unit. On this exercise, we actually had five reserve units from 31 Brigade. They were all working together to achieve their annual training objectives, but also collectively working together to achieve a much higher level than was expected by higher commanders.
So what would you say are some of the benefits of having these different units working together for combined training like this?
Benefits to conducting training like this stem from trying to tackle the problems associated with PRS training. One of the problems that we have is not having the right people on the right exercises. And what we've done in synchronizing our training is trying to enable these people to be on collective exercises and having engaging training for those individuals. At the same time, having enough people available to do the background catch-up training such that at the end of our collective training, all units are able to participate because enough people have attended collective exercises and achieved their threshold training.
What's the likelihood of these units training and working together again in the future?
It's very probable in that we're currently planning with the same units and possibly some other units in our operational plan for next year. And in that, we hope to garner a lot of the efficiencies and continue this momentum that we have, as well as trying to fix some of the problems that we've addressed through our after-action reviews.
And is there anything you'd like to add?
Yes, I'd like to thank the Gray and Simcoe Foresters, the 11th Field Artillery, 31 Service Battalion, and 23 Field Ambulance for their participation on all of these exercises. We would not have been able to do it without their participation and their support. So thank you very much to them.
Thank you, and thanks so much for joining us today, Captain Stevenson.
Thank you very much for having me.